Lecture 14.3 continues the idea of hybridization and sigma and pi bonding in more complex molecules. Now it's time to attack the idea of a pi bond. So I'll start with formaldehyde. Now, first off, before knowing anything about what this looks like in terms of three-dimensional space, this molecule has a sigma bond between carbon and hydrogen, a sigma bond between the other carbon and hydrogen, a sigma bond between carbon and oxygen, and one pi bond. So this is what I will attempt to build for you now. Carbon has s and p valence orbitals. It's in group 4, so I'll go with 4 electrons. Oxygen alone also has s and p valence orbitals. And this time it's in group 6, so I'll have 6 electrons. How many electron regions are around the carbon? 3. So I am going to hybridize 3 of carbon's atomic orbitals. So I will have 3 sp2 orbitals and an unhybridized orbital. Now I realize this looks like an excited state with the 4 electrons, but don't worry, I'm setting this up for bonding. This oxygen has 1, 2, 3 electron regions. So I will also hybridize 3 orbitals. This time the orbitals between blue and yellow, when they are hybridized, are going to be green. And our 6 electrons are placed in the orbitals. Once again, it looks like an excited state, but don't worry, bonds are needed. We have 1 electron in the unhybridized PY orbital. So now, how does this look in terms of bonding? The carbon has 3 sp2 hybridized orbitals. They are oriented at 120 degrees from one another. There are sigma bonds between the carbon and the hydrogen. So each hydrogen brings in its 1s electron, and there is overlap where electron density is between the nuclei. So we have ourselves some sigma bonds. Now, what about the oxygen? The oxygen has 3 electron regions as well, so I will draw the 3 hybrid orbitals. One of these is overlapping with carbon. I hope you can see that would be the sigma bond between carbon and oxygen. And those are our 3 sigma bonds in the molecule. What about these hybrid orbitals here? Well, you notice oxygen has 2 lone pairs, so these would be the lone pairs. Once again, our hybrid orbitals are for sigma bonds and lone pairs. What about the pi bond? Well, remember that we had 1 unhybridized orbital on carbon and 1 unhybridized orbital on oxygen. So I've attempted to draw these for you. The carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen are all in the plane. The unhybridized p orbitals are coming out at you and going back into the plane of the screen. So these 2 unhybridized p orbitals make 1 pi bond. Let me rotate that 90 degrees for you, and hopefully you can see that these are 2 unhybridized p orbitals meeting sideways. So their overlap is going to form a pi bond, where the electrons can be either above or below the plane of the nuclei, but there is a node between them. That was a lot to take in. Shall we try that one more time with a different molecule? How about ethylene? Each of these carbons has 3 electron regions, so they will be sp2 hybridized. So I'm going to draw the red carbon's hybrid orbitals at 120 degrees and the blue carbon's hybrid orbitals at 120 degrees. Now I can draw the overlaps with the hydrogen atoms. So all of these are sigma bonds. This molecule has 5 sigma bonds, and I hope you see them all in the picture. This molecule also has 1 pi-type bond. So here I am showing you the unhybridized p orbitals. They are coming out of the screen and going back into the screen. These would be your overlap that makes a pi bond. So if I can show it to you sideways, the sigma bond is between the atoms, shielding the nuclei from each other. The pi bond is the clasp above and below. Are you ready for a triple bond? Most of the time, the live audience will shake their heads no. Alas, we must go there. So this carbon and this nitrogen each have two electron regions, which means they are sp hybridized. So the carbon has two red orbitals at 180 degrees from one another, and the nitrogen has two blue orbitals at 180 degrees from one another. And then we have the overlap with the hydrogen. So in this molecule, we have a sigma bond between carbon and hydrogen and one sigma bond between carbon and nitrogen. And I've added the nuclei for clarity. So what are these electron regions? Electron region A is a sigma bond. It's an overlap between hydrogen's 1s orbital and carbon's sp hybridized orbital. Region B is another sigma bond. It's the overlap of hybrid orbitals that belong to carbon and nitrogen. And what is C doing? Well, perhaps you notice nitrogen has a lone pair. So that hybrid orbital is holding on to the lone pair. Now, what about the pi bonds? This triple bond has one sigma, which we've accounted for, and two pi bonds. So if carbon and nitrogen are sp hybridized, there must be two unhybridized p orbitals left over. So I'm going to show the px, which are above and below the carbon and nitrogen atoms, and the py, which are coming out of the screen and going back into the screen for you. Overlap of the px unhybridized orbitals makes one of the pi bonds in the x direction. And the overlap of the py unhybridized orbitals makes another pi bond in the y direction. So this theory does a nice job of explaining how the bonds are spread out. Six electrons would not want to occupy the area between the atoms. Instead, we have two electrons between the atoms, two that occupy a probability region above and below the plane, and two electrons that occupy a probability region coming out of the screen and going back into the screen. So for atomic orbital use, the magic number is 4. An atom with two electron regions has two hybridized sp orbitals, which means it has two pure p or unhybridized orbitals left over for pi bonding. An atom with three electron regions has three sp2 orbitals, which means that it has one unhybridized p orbital left over for pi bonding. And an atom with four electron regions has four sp3 orbitals oriented at 109 and no orbitals left over for pi bonding. So let's get back to this molecule. We'd like to know how many atoms with sp hybridization, atoms with sp2 hybridization, and unhybridized p orbitals are there in acrylonitrile. So I will help you get started. This carbon has three electron regions. That means it is sp2 hybridized. And since the magic number is 4, it has one pure p orbital left over. So please think about that for this carbon, and this nitrogen. For your unhybridized p orbitals, certainly you can look at each center and count the unhybridized p, but there's an easier way to do this problem. A pi bond is made when two unhybridized p orbitals come together. So if you want to get unhybridized p orbitals, just take the number of pi bonds in the molecule and multiply by 2. The next question asks, how many sp orbitals and sp2 orbitals are there in acrylonitrile? So I want to point out to you that if this carbon is sp2 hybridized, remember that that involves 3 sp2 orbitals. So do the same for this carbon, and this nitrogen. Here's a very visual question. We want to know which letter represents the sigma bonds in ethylene. So hopefully you realize we're looking for direct overlap, but you should also think about the hybridization around the carbon. How many electron regions should that have when we consider the overlap of sigma between these two carbons? This one asks for the pi bonds in ethine. So not only should you think about what those look like in physical space, but how many are there in the molecule?